locked up. And you got bars, but you're really set free.
Amen.
See, that's the thing. You're either going to pick one side or the other.
That's it.
There's no gray. You can't put your plate on one table and the silverware on the other. No. You're going to have to pick what spot you're going to go to.
That's right.
And then, as I used to say, my mom used to say, you're going to have to play dance to the music you pick.
That's right.
it's true.
Yes.
Would you feel me?
Oh, yeah.
I ain't never been on TV then.
Well, man, don't worry. You're not going to be on TV. You're going to be on the internet.
This would my debut.
You're going to be teaching. You're teaching somebody.
Amen.
Verse 7. And behold, the angel of the Lord came upon him, and a light shone in the prison. And he smote Peter on the side and raised him up, saying, arise quickly, and his chains. And the chains fell from his hand. Amen.
Can you stop there for a moment? From your own personal experience, because you're talking to people also on the internet, that's one reason I want to do this. Somebody has had a problem. How you felt that same experience in prison.
Right, I was going to get you there.
Okay, I got
Amen.
You.
Amen. Amen. The light, it represents truth and the word. All three mean the same. And the light has to shine. You know, in Psalms 19:105, it says that the word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Meaning that the light have to shine in our hearts. Mm-hmm. And in 1 John it says, in him was life, and the life was the light of men. Mm-hmm. And we have to go all the way back to Genesis, is when God created man in his own image, and he blessed him, and he told him to be fruitful, multiply. And he blessed him, and with that spirit, he breathed in man. And that's how God communicated with man through his word. And that was the light that he put in man, that man was different from any other creation. His likeness and his image, that he has the power to choose, to think, and decide.
And that's another reason I think, I don't know there's any scripture will back up what I'm about to say. But when the devil sees us, he's reminded of God, because we were made in the likeness of God.
Right.
And so when he sees us, he gets angry.
Yeah. Amen.
You know, imagine if when we go to hell, all those demons see us. You know, it's like you got a big old target painted on your head. Because why? You're made in the likeness of God, and they're really mad.
That's right. And we go back to Genesis, when he created man, he said, be fruitful, meaning that produce after your own kind. He talking about God. Produce the fruits in his character in you.
Yep.
And he told him that they have dominion. See, that's what we have to find out, that anything, there's nothing can bind us, that everything is at our feet. It's only when we obey God and the abuse of God, that we obey the spirit that God put in us, that our soul, right?
Yeah.
It connects with our spirit, and our spirit tells our soul what to do, and then the soul, the body.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
The light represents a guidance, it's wisdom. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And it said that secondly, that he smote him for him to respond to the light.
Mm-hmm.
If some people sleep real hard, if some people sleep lightly. I can say this when I came to God, I gave my life to God, but I began to go back, and God began to deal with me. I began to use drugs, smoke weed, and I feel like that's what God delivered me from.
Mm-hmm.
And trouble came. God smote me. I went to lock up, right? But I still ain't get it. And by that time, I had got married, and I kept smoking. And then what happened? God, my wife say, well, I want a divorce. And then 6 days later, I got it. I gave my life to God, and I ain't looked back. See, but God, see, the first smoke was the 20 years. I should have seen it then, but I ain't get it.
Mm. Well, look at Moses. He had 40 years. Mm-hmm. And it was in the desert.
Oh, somebody get Psalms 119, read 71 and then read 67.
Psalms 119, 71?
Yeah, and then 67.
Gotcha. 71 says, it is good for me that I have been afflicted, that I might learn thy statutes.
Mm. 67
says, before I was afflicted, I went astray, but now have I kept thy word.
Amen. See, affliction sometimes with the smoke, it means to touch you or afflict you. That the smoke is for you to respond to the light. Everything goes to the light. You have to respond to the light. To come out of bondage, you have to respond to the light. And thirdly, he said, he raised him up, the angel, with the light. And the smoke awakened Peter. Peter had a spiritual awakening, meaning that he woke up. He was attentive to what state he was in. Thirdly, he told Peter to rise up, meaning to take action and respond to the light. Means come up from the dead. Rise up. See, you could be spiritually awoken and still wallowing in your mess. But guess what? It says when he rose up, when Peter rose up in action, the chains fell off.
You know, that sort of reminds me of a sermon I gave once. And it was going something like this. I'm saved. You can still be saved and be on Section 8 housing. You can still be saved sitting there in front of her watching your check bounce. You can be saved owing money to the government, but no one can take God from you. Just because you got some situations, you can still have the light in you. Just because you have bad things around you doesn't mean anything.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
Read Ephesians 5:14.
I'll be right back.
Okay.
5:14. For it is light that makes everything visible. This is why it is said, wake up, O sleeper, rise from the dead, and Christ will shine on you.
Amen. It says that raise up from the dead, and my Bible says that Christ will give you life. Mm-hmm. Meaning that when you respond to the light, Christ will give you wisdom to come up out of bondage. He'll give you a guide to walk about it. But until you raise up out of it, you have to wake up first. Mm-hmm. And then you have to raise up. Amen. See, waking up without raising up ain't nothing. Mm-hmm. Meaning that you know what state you in, mm-hmm. but you haven't come up out of it yet.
Amen.
You know better. Amen. You understand the life. You know what state you in, but you still in it. Mm-hmm. You in bondage. See, and we're going to talk about that later. If you keep clear with that, it'll get you.
Mm-hmm.
And, well, man. And the angel says to him, hold up, what verse that is?
We just read Ephesians.
I'm on 7?
Yeah, 8.
That's 8. What 8 say?
And the angel said unto him, gird thyself and bind on thy sandals. And so he did. And he said unto him, cast thy garment about thee and follow me.
Amen. In order to leave prison, we must prepare ourselves to leave prison. Mm-hmm. That the angels say, gird yourself. Meaning that, gird yourself, meaning to prepare for battle.
Strap up.
That's what it means. And in Ephesians, I don't want to quote it wrong. It was talking about gird yourself, gird your loins, mm-hmm. with truth. See, what I learned about your loins, right? When you